I've done three figures so far. So this will be my fourth one. And this is going to be the Mighty Morphin Zed Pony. Now, the one thing I find weird about these is on the show they're actually announced Puddy, so it's P-U-D-D-Y, but on here it's Putty, which I don't understand why Hasbro have done that, so I do wish they'd cracked it. So anyway, on with the review. So, as I said before, this is my Mighty Morphin Power Rangers Season 2 and Season 3 Zed Pony, because these came along when Lord Zed took over from Rita. Now, I absolutely love these. Like I say, like, the only weird thing I find with these is on the box they've called them Putties, but in the show they're actually called Puddies, which is P-U-D-D-Y, then an S if you want it to be Puddies. So here you can see is the Putty in the box with some of his accessories, but some are behind the window bit. Who looks right. I'll get into the full detail after I've done the box thing. Box looks great. You can see on the side, part of the Putty head, the other part. And if I flip it over, or not flip it over, but turn it round, you'd see the Putty on the back, which is a little bit weird because it's a completely different colour to what you get in the box, which baffles me. But these Putties are completely different from Season 1, as you can see by the design. They have like the knee pads on, there's the armour, my friend actually dresses like a Zed Putty when we do cons, but he doesn't have the Z on his chest. But yeah, looks great. Comes with all the accessories, which I'll explain about when I get him out. And the bad things about the swinger I'll also explain. So anyway, let's get him out of the box and take a look. Good look at him. So here you see the Zed Pony out of the box. Looks great. Love the body armour. Now, my gripe is with this. They don't like the colour because it doesn't look like what it looks like on the show. So that's my downside to this. One of the things they could have, the reason they may have done it like this is on the show when they get hit in the chest part, they kind of, for lack of a better term, blow up. And they kind of go grey when they do that. But what they should have done, which would have been really great, was do alternate pieces for this, so you could kind of have it this color for one scene and then change it to the whitey silver for the other scene. But I do actually have two of these. Here's my second one that I was telling you about that. So, here, Lee Catch. Good catch, Lee. So, yeah, back to the figure I've got out of the box. I kind of sort of get why they may have done it this color, but they should have done alternate body armor and knee pads. The articulation is the same as basically the Rangers. I'll show you around him quick. As you can see, the big Z on his chest, which, geez, that looks so like the one on the show. I should make one for my friend to wear, really. But yeah, love the Z on the chest. If I turn it sideways, you get a slightly different look at the Z. On the back, there's nothing really apart from the back of the shield piece. You may notice from the others that the face sculpt is different. It's quite a bit different, actually, to the normal season one ones, and even to the Fighting Spirit ones, they're different. But yeah, I really like this bunny, except the issues with the color. But one of the things I also really, really like about it is on the show, it looks as though they're wearing almost hoods to hide the way the mask goes around their head and hide their hair. So they've done that on this, which looks amazing. Which I really like that. The eyes are red. The only other thing I really like about this is, and this is also quite funny because I have tried this, the heads can come off and go onto Rangers. So you can make kind of putty Rangers, so to speak, and you can put the Ranger heads onto this, which is really funny because I actually tried this and the one I've got in my bedroom, which looks absolutely amazing. So I actually said I have two of these, but I have three because I got sent two. I got sent another one accidentally, which I could have sent back, but I thought, no, it's worth keeping. So yeah, I love it, and the gloves look phenomenal. Again, with it being grey, you can see the joint holes, which annoy me, which I am thinking about covering up. There is another thing that I thought of that you could cover the joint holes up with if you don't want to try and do it with resin. Use a Sharpie. Color in. But yeah, look pretty. I don't think the body armor comes off. I haven't tried, but I know the dragon shield, if you took the head off and the arm, the glove bits off, you could take the shield off. But that was a pain in the ass to do in itself. So I reckon these ones would be even worse, and I'm actually not even sure these can come off. So anyway, I love the figure. Now let's move on to the accessories. So here are the accessories. You have two putty gloves, which, by the way, I have made, so check that video out. I will put the link to that video in the description of this one. And yes, they do fit me. I also say in that video how to make them. So if you want to make some yourself, you can do. Again, you get two of these gloves. One's a fist, and one is a slightly open fist. Just very slightly, but it is open. And now, this I don't really understand, because they never had this on the show. Now, don't get me wrong, I like it, but they never had it on the show. But it is a great thing to have to go with this figure. But they may have done this because the putties don't have too many accessories. So they may have done that just as a little bonus thing. But they definitely don't have these on the show, because I was watching season 2 of Mighty Morphin last night, so they definitely don't have these on the show. And from what I've seen, these just slide over the fists. And the other bit is the body armor. Or I say the body armor, the exploding effects piece, which happens when they get, like I say, hit in the chest. And they've actually included that to go onto the chest. And they've sculpted some really nice detail into this, actually. It looks fantastic. And this actually has some weight to it. And if I turn it round, you kind of get the tentacle bits that wrap around them. I know they're not actually tentacles, but it's what I think they look like. But yeah, you get that accessory, which looks fantastic. This one that looks like a fireball, which, like I said, wasn't included, but it's a great thing that they have included it. And like I said, the reason I think they've done this is to add another accessory, as those punnies don't have so many accessories. So that's just a fantastic thing to do. So well done for that, Hasbro. I absolutely love the punnies. I just wish you'd done them in the whitish silver, or at least done changeable armor that looks like that, that we could have changed over. But having said that, they still could release some like that, and they might. I don't know this for definite, so don't quote me on this. But yeah, they look absolutely fantastic. Nice accessory to include. Face sculpt is amazing. Put all the accessories on the putty and have a look. So this is the putty with all the accessories on. Looks fantastic. I know he's standing a bit weirdly, but unless you have a stand, to get them to stand properly without tipping over, you have to have their legs in a weird position, because with the effects pieces, it makes them top heavy. Or you can just use a little bit of blue tack on the feet. That always works, because I've done that a few times. But I would always only use like a little dot of it, because if you use a whole bunch of it, it'll make it noticeable that it's stuck down with blue tack. Oh, and another thing I will warn you of, if this has, yes, the feet do have holes in, which is also great for sand stands. But the one thing I will warn you about with that is make sure you don't get blue tack in the holes, because it is a right pain in the arse to get the blue tack out of the holes. So make sure you do not get the blue tack in the holes. It's a nightmare. And remember, actually, the way we had to get it out is kind of scrape it out with a little screwdriver, and we were quite damaged. We were scared we might damage it. So please make sure you don't get the blue tack in the holes. And if you do, just use a screwdriver or a pair of pliers or even a pair of tweezers and gently try and ease it out, because you don't want to damage your finger. So yeah, I absolutely love the putty figure. Yes, it does have its cons, like the colour and stuff, but it also has more pros than cons. And what makes me kind of laugh is they, with the armour, they kind of look like they're wearing waistcoats or tank tops. Oh yeah, and I'll put a little, or I'll put a little thing in the description of a video clip of one of the Z-Putties. I think it's the Rita and Zed's wedding. It's either one or two of them, covering their bits for some reason, I noticed. I don't know why, or whether that was part of the storyline, I don't know. But I just found that so funny, so I will put that, the link to that, in the description, and put comments on that, see, and let me know why you think they're covering their bits. Now, I think I know why, but I'm not gonna say, because I want you guys to guess. Again, thanks to In Demand Toys, who I got this from, and also I want to say thanks to Hasbro for actually doing such amazing figures, even though they do have some flaws, but you are doing your best to correct those, and you're definitely stepping up your game now. I love the way Hasbro doing things. And so anyway, that's the end of this review. Bye bye.